Good afternoon, everyone. Can you all hear me? Great. First, we're going to hear from Auburn University head coach Hugh Freeze. He's going to have with him two players, linebacker Austin Keys, number 6, and tight end Rivaldo Fairweather, number 13. So they should be here shortly. Again, just to repeat, we have with us Auburn University head coach Hugh Freeze, linebacker Austin Keys, and tight end Rivaldo Fairweather. We'll first hear some opening comments from Coach Freeze, and then we'll open it up to the media for questions.
I don't need anyone to tell me when we don't measure up, and that starts with me. And I feel so awful for our incredible fans to travel here. It's incredible to see them, their support for us, and to not perform any better in games this year like this. I promise you that doesn't, I don't need someone to tell me I didn't get it done. And it's, I think our staff and our young men, starting with our staff, starting with me, have got to create a standard of the way we consistently work, consistently compete, and figure out how to be a true team. And that is my goal in 2024. And I'll need these two to help me. And staff to help me, but it's disappointing today for our incredible fans and our support, our administration, that they didn't perform any better. Congrats, Coach Loxley. They came prepared and certainly outplayed us.
Wide open, you know. With I think Hank has something to him for sure. He got 42 touchdowns and one pick in his senior year in high school. There's something to that. And I'm constantly evaluating players, staff, everything. And if we see that my evaluation has been wrong, then we have to change gears and reevaluate to make us better. Then that is
the steps that you take. And the quarterback position will be an interesting one, certainly in spring practice.
I think it's one of the best in the country that we signed, and certainly that's a place we get some depth and some added playmaking ability. And congratulations to Rivaldo. I think he broke
the Auburn tight end receiving record for today. So congratulations to him.
Yes, the receiving corps coming in is absolutely, we're banking on them helping us and making us better and more versatile and can do more things. But it also, you have to play well around every position. You know, and I think we protected well in the first half. Didn't think we ran the ball well in the first half either. And so it's all of it. And defensively, we played really well defensively the second half. But it goes back to that standard. It's not okay just to play really well and you do your assignment for a half. But we are excited about the wide receivers coming in for sure. Scout team, and he has very little protection, and he stands in there and makes throw after throw after throw. I think he has incredible poise for a freshman for sure, and he has great humility, wants to be taught, wants to learn, has a good IQ for the game, understands timing. Even the last throw that I thought the receivers should have kept coming. And that's kind of what Hank anticipated. But he anticipates throws really well. And he's got great poise for a freshman.
Coach, talk about wanting to maybe solidify or cement a team atmosphere moving into 2024. Where do you feel the biggest, what's the biggest disconnect, do you think, right now?
I don't know that this is, just the case for Auburn, but it's certainly something that we are battling some. Is just the disease of me. I think that's in a lot of areas of life now, and we're not exempt to it in our locker room, and I think we've got to face it head on. And it's not everybody for sure, but there's just there's a lot of things that that I'm hopeful that can be a part of the Auburn football program, that, man, we really do care, love, trust one another to put the team first. And I think those are the ones who are going to excel in building sustainable programs that compete at a high level, And so I think that's, we're not the only ones that have to battle that, and we see some that are battling pretty effectively. And, we've got to, particularly when you're disappointed and you're not in the playoffs or you're not, what do you do then? And I think it's those challenges that make football the best training ground there is for life. And there's a lot of lessons that we need to learn for sure. I'm probably my hardest critic. I don't think I did a very good job in a lot of areas this year with our staff and with our team. And I felt like we competed really, really well in some games, and we had some letdowns in others, and we didn't complete some games we could have won. And we weren't consistent in the level of competitiveness that that you have to win at this level, particularly in our conference against Big Ten teams.
We can all say, we need to improve our roster, and we've said that, and we're working on that, and we're going to do that. But even with the roster we had, I felt like we could have gotten more out of it if I had done a better job.
I just want to give God all the glory for allowing me to come out here and play this game and play for this team. But
all the stats and stuff, they don't really mean a lot to me, but I just wish we would just came out with a win here. But again, I just want to thank God for allowing me to play this game and be a part of Auburn history.
About the game plan into this one, you know, what went wrong out there today? Was it execution? Was it, you know, how did you feel about the game plan? And do you guys feel like it was an effective game plan for this one?
Well, obviously, I don't feel like it was an effective one. I didn't get too involved in it for most of the part until this week because of recruiting, and really wanted to kind of evaluate everything about our program. And it, but we didn't run the ball. It starts there, and so we have to go look at the run schemes that we had, and you know, did we not play hard up front? Or, and that's really hard for me to tell. I mean, but they really dominated the line of scrimmage against us. And they did load the box now. They forced us to they had extra hats in the box for sure, and that's when you've got to be able to throw it some. But we didn't protect the passer real well, and it wasn't all the O-line. There were sometimes the backs didn't get the protection right. But anytime you struggle like we did, I don't feel like the plan was great.
Here. Austin, you guys get off to a slow start on defense. They score 21, but after that, did a really good job holding them down. What does that say about this defense, kind of this team, those guys coming back next year, that y'all kept fighting after getting into, you know, such a hole like that early?
I would say it's just we started with, like, a few miscommunications, a few missed tackles, something that we critically need. You know, we got to make open field tackles and stuff like that. But, like, for our returners, like, I talked to Freeze not too long ago and told him, like, we trying to set a foundation, and we really just need a standard for next year. So.
What do you credit that first quarter to, kind of thinking back? Did you see that coming? Were you surprised at how that went?
Yeah, I was real surprised. Really thought defensively we had – I know we were playing some young kids, but really thought we would start faster and could match up with these guys. And, you know, they hit us with a big screen on the first drive, and everything just kind of snowballed. But we had a ton of misalignments and miscommunications right in the early part of the game that really cost us. And, you know, we got to look at ourselves as coaches first to see – you know, why we weren't more effective in getting those things communicated with our kids.
Got time for two more.
Didn't do a very good job this year. What would you have done differently?
Well, I mean, that's, you know, every game's different. I mean, if you go look at the Georgia game, I wish we'd have protected better because we had some shots. If you go to the Ole Miss game, I wish we'd have gone with more tempo and you know, if you go to the Alabama game, I wish we, you know, fielded punts better, and I wish we'd have taught 4th-and-31 defense better. And, you know, but ultimately, if you have to look at yourself as coaches, and our kids are going to make some mistakes sometimes, but, you know, in those critical moments, are our kids coached well enough to get it done? And when we don't get it done, I have to look at myself. And so every game's different as to what you would have done differently. But, you know, you certainly don't enjoy having to say that or feel that. But that's the way I feel right now. And, yeah, we're going to improve the roster and all of that. But, you know, we still could have gotten more out of this season, I believe, for our young men and our wonderful fans.
One more question.
Coach, what's your biggest takeaway here at the end of this first year about where you guys are at?
We're incredibly blessed to be at Auburn, incredibly blessed by our administration and fans. And it hurts like heck to let them down and not compete on given days. But my takeaway is that I'm still as confident as ever that this can be an elite football program again, and it takes great recruiting, but it also takes player-led teams that put team first and the standard of the team every single day first. And
We're still learning that, and we've got to demand it as coaches, and we can't waver from it when we get back in January, and I'm looking forward to the leadership of our team doing that.
Thank you, Coach Freeze. Austin and Rivaldo, thank you all very much.
Boy.